Things to do in Nashville, Tennessee. Hello guys! Welcome to my YouTube channel, Travel the World. If you want to visit any other country in the next video, then tell us in the comments. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Today, I am going to talk about Nashville. Nashville is the capital and most populous city of the U.S. state of Tennessee. The city is the county seat of Davidson County and is located on the Cumberland River. It is the 23rd most populous city in the United States. Known for its energy and vibrancy, Nashville is one of the most famous music destinations in the world. It's actually nicknamed Music City because of its significance to the biz. Its streets are filled with bars, clubs, concert halls, music studios, and more recording stations than you can shake a microphone at. To find out the best places to visit in Nashville, Tennessee, stay with us till the end. Let's begin with the interesting and breathtaking places present in Nashville, Tennessee. Music Row. The area around Music Square is known as Music Row and is the heart and soul of the nation's music industry. Music Row is where you'll find such important landmarks as RCA Studio B, the recording facility credited as the birthplace of the unique Nashville sound that defined so many big hits of the 1960s. It's now a teaching facility, and tours can be arranged through the Country Music Hall of Fame and Museum. For country fans, this is the place to come. In addition to numerous souvenir and memorabilia shops and museums devoted to music and musicians, there are many memorials and plaques dedicated to some of the sites associated with music. Also found here in the hub of Nashville are names connected to other musical genres, such as gospel and Christian music, including recording studios, record labels, and radio and TV stations. It's a great area to get your music fix, whether you're sightseeing, shopping, or dining. Ryman Auditorium. The Ryman Auditorium, home of the Grand Ole Opry from 1943 to 1974, is again being used to host performances of the famous radio show. Originally opened in 1892 as the Union Gospel Tabernacle, the Ryman, often referred to as the Carnegie Hall of the South, has been restored and now also features regular classical concert series, bluegrass shows, musical theater, and television tapings. The building also serves as a museum with a variety of exhibits relating to its rich past. Guided and self-guided tours are available, and be sure to try your hand at cutting a record of your own in the Ryman's recording studio. Fun backstage tours are available, but book ahead in order to avoid disappointment. Tennessee State Museum. Housed in a brand new facility that opened in 2018, the Tennessee State Museum is a great way to learn more about the rich history of this beautiful state and its diverse population. Located adjacent to Bicentennial Capitol Mall State Park, this spacious state-of-the-art museum now covers an area of 137,000 square feet and is chock-a-block full of interactive displays and multimedia presentations, which bring the state's past to life. Among the museum's diverse collections are artifacts relating to Tennessee's role in the Civil War, including period weapons and furniture. There's also a sizable collection of artworks and paintings and displays related to music and musicians. Other notable features include a theater and an education and learning center, plus an on-site gift shop. Radnor Lake State Park. While there's certainly no shortage of great walking routes in town, those seeking a pleasant country hike couldn't do much better than to pay a visit to Radnor Lake State Park, Radnor Lake State Natural Area. This beautiful nature preserve covers an area of 1,402 acres on the city's outskirts and includes 6 miles of easy hiking trails, which meander around the lake and through its large expanse of woodland. One trail is also available for biking and dog walking. Highlights include the chance to view native wildlife. Otters, mink, beavers, bobcats, and deer are common sights, as well as explore an informative visitor center with educational displays relating to these creatures and the park's native flora. It's also a popular spot for bird watchers thanks to its frequently spotted population of herons and owls. With a little advance planning, you can also participate in fun guided activities, such as wildflower walks, stargazing and nature hikes, and canoe trips. Fort Nashboro. Located on the banks of the Cumberland River, and one of the best things to do in Nashville for free, Fort Nashboro was reconstructed in recent years to provide visitors with an accurate depiction of life in pioneer days. The fort was established in 1780 after James Robertson led settlers across the frozen Cumberland River. While the original fort only lasted until 1792, this modern-day reconstruction provides a fascinating insight into the life and times of early Nashvillians. start your exploration at the on-site interpretive center. In addition to addressing the conditions for the pioneers as well as offering great views over the Cumberland River, it also features displays relating to local Native American history, including an interesting sculpture made from feathers. A number of historically accurate replica buildings are also located on the property, including fortifications, log cabins, and block houses. Cheekwood Botanical Gardens and Museum of Art. Cheekwood is well known for its lovely gardens and park-like setting, and is a splendid place to visit for a few hours. Highlights of this beautiful 55-acre estate-like property include the Woodland Sculpture Trail with its four greenhouses with camellias and orchids, as well as a learning center with contemporary art galleries. The city's Museum of Art is also housed within the 1920s Georgian-style mansion, displaying a fine collection of American art from the 19th and 20th centuries. Nearby is the Tennessee Agricultural Museum with its collection of historic farm artifacts, as well as collections of rural Tennessee prints and folk art sculptures. The Frist Art Museum is another gallery worthy of a visit. Located downtown in the city's attractive old post office building, it's notable for its many visiting art exhibits from around the world. Country Music Hall of Fame and Museum. The Country Music Hall of Fame and Museum is set in a stunning building in the heart of downtown Nashville, its tall windows resembling the keys of a piano. The museum features a multimedia display of historical performances, costumes, instruments, gold records, and memorabilia. Other highlights include a Cadillac that once belonged to Elvis, a massive 40-foot guitar, a tour bus, and a recording booth. Guided tours of the nearby historic RCA Studio B are also available. Country music fans should also pay a visit to the Johnny Cash Museum and Cafe, notable for its vast collection of artifacts and memorabilia related to one of the country's leading music legends. Also, while not strictly country music related, the Musicians Hall of Fame and Museum is worth visiting for its displays and exhibits related to recorded music and its stars. The General Jackson Showboat. The General Jackson Showboat is another great way to get your country music fix. This modern four-deck paddlewheel showboat was built to resemble a steamship from the 1800s and offers a variety of cruises on the Cumberland River. One of the most popular options is to book one of their dining and show packages. If you're looking for fun things to do at night in Nashville, this pleasant outing offers a unique view of the cityscape from the water. A highlight is passing under the John Siegenthaler Pedestrian Bridge, which you should also take the opportunity to cross at least once during your stay for its great views of the river and boat traffic. The Grand Ole Opry. A number of attractions are associated with the famous Opryland name, the former music industry-themed amusement park that once graced Nashville. Today, the name is associated with the Grand Ole Opry, the paddlewheel showboat, the General Jackson, the Gaylord Opryland Resort and Convention Center, and the huge Opry Mills Shopping Mall. Grand Ole Opry radio shows have been broadcast from here since 1925, and visitors can enjoy regular shows starring famous country stars in the Grand Ole Opry House itself, along with fun backstage tours. Other music-themed things to do and explore in Nashville are the Willie Nelson and Friends Museum and General Store, and the Texas Troubadour Theater, with its eclectic mix of musical productions. Fans of classical music can catch the Nashville Opera and Nashville Symphony, which performs at the Schermerhorn Symphony Center. The Nashville Parthenon. Nashville's most iconic landmark, the famous reproduction of Athens' Parthenon, is located in Centennial Park and is just a short walk west of the city center. Originally built of wood in 1897 to commemorate the state's centenary, it was later rebuilt in cement on the same site. Today, it stands as an impressively accurate full-scale replica of the original Greek temple. Be sure to pop inside too. Here, you'll find the city's impressive permanent art collection consisting of 63 works by 19th and 20th century American painters, along with a 42-foot-high replica of the statue of the goddess Athena Parthenos covered with gold leaf. Also worth seeing are the replicas of the famed 5th century BC Parthenon marbles. Andrew Jackson's Hermitage. The former home of America's 7th president, Andrew Jackson, is undoubtedly one of the most picturesque spots in Nashville. Located just a few minutes' drive east of the city center, the Hermitage was originally constructed in 1819 and fully rebuilt 25 years later after a devastating fire. now fully renovated to look just as it would have during Jackson's time. He lived here from 1837 to 1845. This splendid old mansion now houses a fascinating museum with numerous exhibits and displays focusing on both his private and public lives. If you're able, be sure to invest a little time to participate in a formal guided tour of the property. Other fun activities include wagon rides and themed events such as ghost tours. The Tennessee State Capitol. The Tennessee State Capitol, built on the most prominent hill in downtown Nashville, was designed in a simple neoclassical style and is capped with a temple-like cupola. Started in 1845 and made mostly of local Tennessee limestone, this impressive structure is the anchor of the Bicentennial Capitol Mall State Park, linking the legislature with the downtown core. Free guided tours are available on the hour, 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., and 1 p.m. to 3 p.m., as are self-guided tours, and the public galleries are open to visitors on legislative days. Bicentennial Capitol Mall State Park is itself worth exploring. This 19-acre site commemorates the state's 200th anniversary and includes a huge granite map embedded in the concrete plaza, along with numerous fountains and statues of Tennessee-born presidents Andrew Jackson and Andrew Johnson. So, which of the following places you have liked the most and why? Tell us in the comments. Also, don't forget to like the video as well. Thanks for watching.